फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू लेसन इन द कंप्यूटर दैट इज अबाउट क्रिएटिंग ए डॉक्यूमेंट और डिजाइनिंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट। ओके, फर्स्ट क्रिएटिंग ए डॉक्यूमेंट एंड इफ वी आर वर्किंग विद द एक्सिस्टिंग डॉक्यूमेंट देन हाउ टू मेक आवर डॉक्यूमेंट अट्रैक्टिव, व्हाट एंड ऑल चेंजेस वी कैन मेक इन आवर डॉक्यूमेंट, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट दैट। ओके, सो व्हाट इज दिस अबाउट? ओके, it is an MS Word, is an application software. Okay, it is an application software where we can write stories, CSS, we can make our documents here. Okay, we can create documents here. So let us first begin with how to create a document in MS Word. So first, when you start your computer, okay, first click on start, then a list of things appears, then you have to click on all programs. Then you have to click on MS Word 2007. So here appears, when you click on these things, when you click on these given instructions, this page appears, children. Can you see this? So the page appears in this way. Okay, this is how the Microsoft Windows 2007 page looks like. So here, number of options are provided, dear students. Okay, so depending on the need, we can utilize each and everything here. So let us see what are these things. Okay, ribbon is, you can use what and all things you want here by writing, and as you write in your notebook with your pencil and eraser. Okay, you don't use pencil and eraser here, you have to type using the keyboard, and you can take, you can also use mouse if you want to use any of these options. So let us see what and all is there here, children. Here font is given, then some colors, color palette is given, then font size is given. So let us see how to begin first. Okay, if you are creating something, if you want to write something, okay, this is how a blank page looks like. This is the page. So there is, what is the title bar? So the blue color line which is on the top, this is called the title bar. Here we can give a name to our document here. If you haven't given any name to your document, this appears here, document 1 Microsoft Word. If you have not given any name to your document, what appears here, children? Document 1 Microsoft Word. You can see this here. This is called as title bar. The first blue color line is title bar. Then below that title bar, we have a menu bar. Okay, when you go to a restaurant, the waiter, he'll get you a menu. What and all things are there, what and all items or recipes are available in the restaurant, isn't it? So this is also a menu bar. So number of options are provided here, like home, insert, page layout, preferences, mailings, reviews, etc. So we'll get to learn this in detail further. So below that, we are having some options of changing our handwriting and the font size, how to change font size. So let us learn in detail now. So here we are having cut, copy and paste options also. So let us see how we have to use that while writing and what is the use of all these things. Let us learn in brief. So the title bar, the blue color line which is appearing here, this is the title bar. Below this we have menu bar where we have got a number of options which we can use in our writing and when we are working. So let us see what is this about cut, copy and paste. So you can see, when you open this, you can see a blinking line here, children. When you open your system and when you open MS Word 2007 and when you want to write something, okay, it all, so a vertical line, this is called as cursor. Okay, this is called as cursor, children. It will be blinking on your screen. Let us suppose how to type on the keyboard. So let us suppose you want to type the frame of computer, C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R, computer. Then, so simply you have to give a gentle touch, gentle click on C and then release it quickly. Do not press it for a long time. Otherwise, the C letter appears for the number of times as long as you're pressing the key C. So how you have to click using the keyboard? Just a click. Give a quick click. What is it called? Quick click. Okay. Give a quick click and release it quickly. Okay. Then same with the other letters also. C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R. Okay, so this way. So you have to just give a gentle click, then release it quickly. Do not press it for a long time. What happens if you keep your finger for a long time, children? The same letter may appear as many times, number of times, as long as your finger is on the particular key. So you have to press it, click it quickly and release it quickly. So computer. So while writing in your notebook, you did finger space, isn't it? So what is the option here in the keyboard? Space bar. Space bar. To give space, you have to click on space bar. Space bar is the button, children. So space bar, click space bar. Automatically your cursor moves here. Okay. Then black type, yes, ease. Then again, if you want to give space, click space bar and A. Like it when a computer is an electronic machine. Okay. Suppose if you want, you have written a sentence, computer is an electronic machine. Then you want to come to the next line. So when you want to come to the next line, press enter key to write the second point. Okay, press the enter key. You get into the second line automatically. Okay, the cursor appears here. Okay, the cursor, so let us suppose you have written a first sentence, computer is an electronic machine. When you press enter key, the cursor appears here. Then you can type one more sentence here. Like this, you can make points and you can simply skip to the next line. And let us suppose you have done some mistake and you want to erase it. How do you suppose computer, you have typed the computer and R you have typed two times. So this is not necessary. So you want to erase this R. So what you have to do? So you have to simply, with the help of mouse, click here, then you can click backspace. Okay, give it click on backspace, then this gets erased automatically. Okay, while writing, when you notice that while writing only, if you have noticed that when the cursor is here, simply if you click backspace, you can simply erase this. Okay, if you click on backspace, this spelling mistakes you can correct. You can correct this. Suppose while typing, you have typed the R two times. So simply what you have to do at the time, click on backspace. If you click on backspace, this gets erased. So when you want to erase something, you have to use the key backspace. So this is about the keys. And let us suppose you are creating a document about your friends. Okay, about your friends, children. So what you have to do here, you are collecting some information about your friends. You are collecting some information about your friends. And so let us write the heading friends first. This should be in the heading. Take your cursor, move your cursor here, and you can write the heading in the center as friends. So as this is the heading, you want to make it bold, isn't it? Heading should be in big letters. So if you want to do that, you have to take your mouse, point here, click on B. Okay, B means bold. Here I means italics. If you click on bold, the letters will get bold. Okay, then the size, the font size also you can change, children. You can change your font size also. A list of numbers will be given, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, if you have, it depends upon you what is the font size you have to choose there. Okay, if you click on 14, the font size becomes, the font size automatically changes. Okay, if you have, if you want to change the font size, you want to say, make it bold. Okay, click on font size. Okay. Click here on the font, then here. You can click here, then you can select the desirable number here, then this changes. If you want to make it into italics, I means italics here. Simply select this and click on the italics, that is I here. This comes in italics format. Okay, this appears, the heading appears in italic handwriting. Okay, children, here the options are given, bold, italic. Cursive will be given. If you want to underline that, select that and simply click on underline. Then it will be underlined like this here. So let us suppose the information you are gathering about here. Suppose first name, class, school, father name, mother name, hobbies, and something favorites. Their favorites like this. So you have to write type everything here like this. First name, then class, school. Father's name, mother's name, hobbies, and favorite food, favorite like anything. You are collecting some data about your 10 friends. You have to collect this data of 10 of your friends. So what will you do first? You have the beginning in the page one like this. Then you have to write all these things. You have to fill up this. Okay. Write something. Your friends' name, friends' class, school. Okay. Then their father's name, mother's name, hobbies. So what will you do now? You want to do the same for your 10 friends. Will you write this again? First, you have to write all these things children. Okay, do not fill in the details first. First, what will you first write these things? Okay, first type these things here. Then the same thing you have to make for your other friend also. So what will you do? As I told you, if you are making these for your 10 of your friends, what will you do? You have to, with the help of mouse, click here and drag the mouse till last one here. Okay, till the last here. From here to here you have to drag. And if you drag this, this matter will get selected. Okay, this gets selected. Then click on copy. Okay, then this matter gets copied. Then scroll down the mouse. Then you click on paste. The same thing will be appears one more time. So the number of times you want to paste, you can paste it, children. First, what you have to do? What are we doing here? Our teacher asks us to write the same thing. Write this hard work for 5 times. So simply you have to write 5 times, 10 times, isn't it? But in case of computer, if you want to copy the same thing, if you want to write the same thing for the other person, you need not to type again. You can simply, what you can do, you can copy the matter. So copy this thing. How will you copy this? Okay, click on here. Give it click here using your mouse, then drag this. Select the content, what you want. Okay, select the content, then click on copy. Okay children, then you can paste it wherever you want. Okay, the number of times you want, you can paste it. You need not to type this again and again. So, this is about copy and paste. Then what about cut, children? What is this cut? You are having a picture of scissor. Here we can see. So, this symbol means cut. Okay, what to cut? Will you cut something here? Okay, why do we use scissors to cut clothes, paper, isn't it? What has to be cut here? What do you want to cut here? Okay, let us learn that. So let us suppose we have begun this with name, school, father, mother. Now, let us suppose if you want to change this, what do you want to make the changes? You want his father name first, mother name first. You want to replace these things. These hobbies must be placed first. So what and all things you want to appear first here, and these things should come last. At that time we can use cut here. Okay. What and all you want, let us suppose this name, class and school, if you want to place it here below this, okay, simply you can select this and click on cut, okay, cut, and you can paste it again wherever you want, okay, whichever the matter you want to replace, okay, use it to replace that. Like suppose if you don't want this in the beginning itself, and if you want this below this thing, you can simply cut it from here and again you can paste it below this. Okay, you need not to erase all these things using backspace or delete and type it again. Simply you can use the cut option. You can cut this and you can paste it here again. Okay children, so this is how we use cut, copy and paste. So students, now let us suppose if you want to work on any existing document. What is this existing document? The document or file which is already present in your computer, which is already existing in your computer. So how to do? First, click on office button. Okay, if you want to open some file, you should be aware of the name of that file, isn't it? You should know what is the name of that file which you want to open, or you should know location, where is it. So how to do? First, click on the office button, then select open. Then if you know the name, you can just click on that and the file opens there. So let us suppose you want to create a new document. Let us, you have created a small story and you have typed the whole story on the screen of your computer. You have made some paragraphs and you have written, and now you are working on that document. Suppose your story is health is well. Okay, you have typed a story now. Health is well. So now, what to do here? You have to make necessary changes here. Okay, you have typed the story now, and let us see what you do. You want to check everything and you want to make some necessary changes. Okay, so you have written a long story which is in 2 to 3 pages or some 4 pages. Okay, so how to do, what to do if you want to go to the end of the line. Okay, so let us learn. So how to move to the beginning, how to move to the end, how to save the document and how to do format here and how to make our document colorful. So after writing the document, if you want to save the document, if you want to save the document, children, you can save it as your, with your desired name, and you can give a location to your file. Okay, click on the office button, then a list of things appears. Click on save. Then you can give a new name to your file and you can save it with your new name, whichever you want to give. So, and now you want to make some necessary changes. Okay, children, then you can use these arrow keys in the keyboard to go to the next page. Okay, then you can also use the shortcut keys. You can also go to the shortcut keys, like if you click on go, you go to the first page and you get to the end of the story. You come to the end of the line. So if you want to save, what to do, children? Click on save. Then file menu appears, then click on save as. Then you can give a new name to your document or your created file. So let us see some more options here. So how to format a document. Okay, here number of options will be given as I told you, children. So what is this font? If you want, so we have written a paragraph here. If you want to change the handwriting, if you want your paragraph or your story to be italics, so simply you can select the whole paragraph, children. You can click the mouse, give a gentle click with the mouse, drag it, select the content, and can simply click on italics, then your handwriting will be changed into italics. Okay, then you can also use some color templates here, children. Here, a small option is given here, paragraph. This is called as alignment. Okay, this is called as alignment, children. Here we have left alignment, center alignment, right alignment, and justified alignment. What is this? If you want left alignment, what happens? So the paragraph, your paragraph will be closer with the lines of your paragraph will come closer to the left margin. If you select right alignment, the lines in your paragraph will come closer to the right margin. Then if you want center alignment, the lines of your paragraph will be assembled in the center. Then justified alignment. What is this justified alignment? All the lines in the paragraph will be equally expanded, not towards left, not towards right. They will be equally expanded to both left and right margins. So if you want to make some changes regarding the handwriting, bold option will be there, italics will be there, and underline will be there. Okay, so if you click on bold, if you select the matter, and if you click on bold, it will thicken the letter. Okay, it will thicken the text you have written. Then italic means what happens? Italics, your letters will be slant towards right. Okay, then if you want anything to be underlined, you can simply click on underline wherever you want to make it underlined. Then children, so if you want to move to the last line of your paragraph, if you click on end, you will simply get to the last line of the paragraph. So how to move? You can use the scroll button on the mouse. You can use the scroll button on the mouse to get to get down and verify, to check wherever you want to make changes. If you want to see, go to the next page. Simply you can scroll, go to the next page, and if you want, you can see simply what and all things you have to make changes. Simply scroll using the button which is present on the mouse. Then children, let us suppose in the paragraph you have written a story, then you want to replace it. Okay children, let us suppose you want to replace some word. So in the story, you have written something, a story about king. Okay, you have written a small story about king. Okay, wherever you find the word king, you want to replace that word king with ruler. Okay, you want to replace this king with the word ruler. Will you go to the word, will you go and search everywhere, wherever king is there, will you go there and make it, give it backspace and type ruler again? No, you can simply, without doing this, you have a simple trick where you can find this word and replace. What is this called? This is called find and replace. Okay, you can simply do this, children. What do you want to find? replaced with ruler. So this is how we, within seconds you can replace the words using this replace and find children. So then again let us see what is undo and redo. Okay, what is undo and redo? Okay, so you'll be having this on your screen. You can see this arrow marks here, children. This represents undo and redo. Okay, what is the function of undo? It cancels the previous action. Okay, what is the previous action? Let us suppose you have added some color to your paragraph here. Simply you have typed it, so black in black letters it appeared in the black letters. So by writing you wanted to change this handwriting into red. Okay, you have selected from the color palette and you have changed this and the letters are appearing in red color. Okay, now after that you are thinking, you have changed this into red color now. And now you are thinking, no, it's not looking good. Let us change this. So if you click on this undo,